Okay, salam alaikum. This is the third part of the series of webinars held by or organized by Dr. Raed Al-Dhalemi. Of course, we are very grateful for his knowledge, sharing his knowledge with us. And we really thank him very much. Of course, these lectures are present on YouTube. And of course, Dr. Raed agreed to place them on YouTube so that many dentists can see these lectures whenever they want. So I don't want to take more of Dr. Raed's time. Dr. Raed, whenever you're ready, you can start. Thank you.
شكرا جزيلا استاذنا الغالي ودكتورنا العزيز الاستاذ الدكتور حسين الحويزي الدكتور عبد الله الموسوي، شكرا لك جزيلا يعني، وان شاء الله اكون عند حسن ظنكم. وهذه المحاضره الثالثه الاخيره من ضمن هذه السلسله، وان شاء الله ما تكون ضمن يعني ما تكون محاضره اخيره ضمن التعاون بيني وبين المؤسسات اللي اشتغل وياها وبين نقابه اطباء اسنان العراق، واوعدكم بمزيد من المحاضرات إن شاء الله وإن سمح الوقت. طبعا اليوم راح نبلش بالجزء الثالث والأخير من محاضرتنا اللي هي تتحدث عن الكلينيكال ابديتس ان اندودونتيك مايكرو سيرجري كونسبتس. مثل ما تعرفون بلشنا بالمحاضرة الأولى بالانديكيشن كونترا انديكيشنز، وأخذنا حيثيات الموضوع من الأسسمنت إلى وين وير and what we should do in order to start our endodontic surgery. المحاضرة الثانية التركيز كان والفوكس mainly in the surgical part، وحكينا على الارمامنتيريوم والنيو ابديت بالماتيريال. هسه راح يعني تكون clinical pictures for both presented lectures in modern view. طبعا لاحظت عند الكثيرين مدى يميز بين مصطلحين اللي هما الاندودونتيك سيرجيكال بروسيجر والمايكرو سيرجري اور بري ابيكال سيرجري. لهذا اقتضى التنويه انه there is an classification of endodontic surgical procedure اللي يشمل السيرجيكال درينيج، هو ضمن الكلاسيفيكيشن مال endodontic procedures surgical endodontic، طبعا بنوعيه الانسيجن اند درينيج والكورتيكال تريبينيشن راح نحكي عليها. السكند بارت اوف ذا كلاسيفيكيشن اوف اندودونتيك سيرجري اللي احنا هو المين كونسيرن مالتنا اللي هو البيري راديكولار سيرجري اللي يشمل كيوريتج اند بايوبسي روت اند ريسكشن روت اند بريباريشن اند فيلينج اللي هو هذا المين كونسيرن اوف اور ليكتشر، كوركتيف سيرجري وراح نحكي عليها اليوم همين، الميكانيكال سواء بنوعيها او ميكانيكال اور ريزوربتيف، also الروت ريسكشن الامبيوتيشن وراح نعطي اكزامبل عن الروت ريسكشن امبيوتيشن، والهيميسكشن. الجزء الثالث من الـ classification of endodontic surgical procedure هو الـ replacement surgery، إما replantation أو the implant surgery أو الـ endodontic implant، مع العلم أنه صار outdated ما عاد يستعمل بالوقت الحالي، root form osseo integration implant. طبعا أحب أنوه على شغلة بالنسبه للدنتال امبلانت، مثل ما نعرف انه الدنتال امبلانت اول من بدا وتطور كان بالبدايه حكر على السيرجن، بعدين صار الاندودونت البيريودونتست، تمام، بعدين الامريكان اسوسيشن اوف بروستودونست allow the prostodonist to do the dental implant. In last 5 years the American Association of Endodontists recognized dental implant as a part of a specialty. شنو يعني؟ يعني أنت as an endodontist, you are legally authorized to insert an implant. So the implant is not related to the surgery only. For that, the dental implant also goes within the classification of related subject to endo. الانسجن اند درينج ما راح نضيع وقت بيها اللي تعرفوها كلكم هي عباره عن انسجن in the most fluctuant area in order to extra or removal of exudate or removal of all the pus material from removal of the pus material from the confined bunny lesion. The periradicular surgery, اللي هي part also part of microsurgery or microendodontic surgery, which is removal of granulation tissue, removal of the lesion in order to submit this specimen for histopathological evaluation. Root tip resection, طبعا حكينا عليه بتفاصيل دقيقة جدا بس راح اسوي لكم ريفيو سريع حتى تعرفون اللي هو عباره عن opening flap, resection of the root, filling of the root tip, then post operative radiograph. هذا هو part of the classification. السواح and Walker assess the indication of periapical surgery. وبالاخير طلعوا الى two broad classification. اللي هم 60% من الانديكيشنز بايولوجيكال و 40% هي تكنيكال فاكتورز. البايولوجيكال من اسمها بايولوجيكال ريليتد تو ذا سيمبتومز، لكن التكنيكال هي ريليتد تو presence of the post crown and removed canal fillings and application error, let's say fracture instrument or etc. مثل وانطي example هنا اللي هي this case and successful root canal treatment lead to a fracture or broken of the handpiece. This at this case the endodontist decided to start an apical surgery. So we see exposure of the area, extruded of the fractures, then fillings, which is the standard endodontic procedure. It's good practice to take a radiograph following the placement of root ended material. Why? انت ضروري جدا ورا اي اكس راي ورا اي كيس ان تاخذ اكس راي. ليش؟ حتى تتاكد من ثلاث شغلات. اول شيء adequate root end resected and no remnant of the root tip. Okay. Root ended filling material well condensed, مو شترد. No access of root filling material. شوفوا هذا الريسكشن. إذا تباوع على الاكس راي anterior posteriorly, the resection is perfect. While we will go from mesiodistal angulation, we're gonna find the section is incomplete. For that, you need always for any evaluation two radiograph perpendicular to each other in order to confirm the right resection. Mulvan et al. عندهم classification للتريتمنت outcome. وإذا تتذكرون بالمحاضرة السابقة بنهاية المحاضرة حكينا على successful of the treatment بمداخلة من استاذنا الفاضل دكتور حسين وضمن أحد الأسئلة. بالسلايدات القادمة راح نفصل بهالclassification. The radiographical classification of the treatment outcome following endodontic surgery described as I mentioned by Molven et al. is often used as there is a good correlation with histological assessment. دائما نربط بيناتهم. عندنا four category شنو هي؟ أول شيء complete healing اللي هو هذا الريدر. Incomplete healing scar يعني procedure successful but incomplete. Uncertain healing I'm not sure. Failure. Those four categories هم main classification of the assessment of post-operative procedures. Some cases may appear initially as a failure, but in the course of days is going to improve equally. Late failure, 10 years and more, and you should have the cases after 10 years, there is a failure. ليش؟ بيعزو الريسيرشر إلى هي الروت اند فلينج ماتيريال وغالبا كان الأمالغام. Look to this case. Surgical bunny defect after endodontic surgery. هاي يعني أنا مسوي السيرجري. هنا شوف significant reduction in the size. البوني ديفكت صار أصغر و more confined. When we proceed, we're gonna find complete bone healing. بالمناسبة الإيفالويشن مالتي ما بس راح يعتمد على complete bone healing, but also it's gonna depend on periodontal ligament and lamina dura. We should evaluate the whole periodontia, not only the periapical osseous part. حتى أنت تقدر تقيم the success of your treatment, you should depend on the evaluation of two parts, the periapical area, the periodontium and lamina dura. نجي على أول treatment اللي هو كلتنا نطمح إلى, sorry, أول outcome اللي هو كلتنا نطمح إلى وكلتنا نريده اللي هو successful outcome. أول شيء عندي clinical. شلون أنا أقول clinically هذا successful outcome. When there is no symptoms. ماكو أي symptoms. هاي انتهينا منها. Radiographically. أني إمتى أعتمد على الراديوغراف إنه success. The treated tooth should show a normal periodontal ligament width, okay, or slightly increase, not wider than twice of normal periodontal ligament space. يعني مو بس bone healing لا عندي إما normal periodontal ligament أو even if it's wide but not wider than twice. The periradicular refraction should be eliminated. وعندي الاوسيوس باتن سوري الاوسيوس باتن اللي هو الترابيكولي should be normal. There should be no root resorption evidence. A clinical criteria cannot be used to determine the amount and type of repair histopathologically. يعني انت تشوفه راديوغرافيكلي بس هذا ما له علاقه بالهيستوباثولوجي او الهيستولوجي ايفالويشن. Finally, I need regeneration of the cementum and periodontal ligament over the resected root apices. However, in many cases, there is a healing, but what kind of healing? It's a fibrous tissue, which is regarded as a scar. Look to this case, guys, my friends. هاي pre-operative radiograph. نشوف after 20 months look to the healing and after 8 years look to the periodontal ligaments. Not only guys or my friends, not only the periapical area, but also I need you to inspect the lamina dura and the periodontal membrane. The second category, incomplete outcome.
which is with sub-degree from the complete healing. Clinically, there is no sign and symptoms, same as complete outcome. But it's different radiographically. How? There is a partial regeneration, not complete regeneration. Shinu sebab may be due to formation of a fibrous tissue, or especially if you have a through and through lesion, open window lesion, where both buccal and lingual cortical plate have been perforated by infection during the surgical procedure. But yeah, the healing is going to take time and it's going to be healed by fibrous tissue. Look, that's what I mean. There is a reduction in the size of the periapical bony defect by bone formation, but there is irregular bone borders. Okay? Even when we advance in time, the bone healing is gonna accelerate, but still irregular. Look to this case, and a radiographical example about what I illustrated. Perioperative radiograph, 13 months, we see still we have incomplete outcome, and even after 2 years, we're gonna find the healing is incomplete. This is incomplete outcome. Uncertain outcome, which is the third category. Clinically, there is a vague symptoms. The patient ما يعرف يفسرش عنده. Vague. Include mild discomfort, feeling of a pressure, fullness around the treated tooth. يقول لك اكو شيء مضايقني. Radiographically هو الأهم. Partial regeneration. Look, as here. Look to another case, radiographical case. I have a preoperative radiograph. And 1 year, and even 8 years, and we still have incomplete bone healing, and the patient complained from vague symptoms. So it's gonna be the same as of incomplete outcome, but with clinical symptoms. The unsuccessful outcome, اللي هو كلتنا ما نحب النايتمير, clinically, presence of sign and or symptoms in the periradicular disease, including root fracture maybe. Radiographically, أصلا ماكو عندك أي regeneration. There is no regeneration. إما هذا الفيلير happen immediately or after a while. Look to this case. Surgical bony defect. And look after period of time during the follow-up period. You see, there is an increase in the bone lesion, not reduce in the bone lesion. Referral. شبابنا, زملائنا, أصدقائنا الأعزاء. قمة الدنتال ماتوريشن or experience maturation is to learn how to refer a case, when to refer the case. You should know your limits. أبد مو عيب إنه أنت تحول case. All of us, we have limitation. And you should respect your limitation. ما بينا واحد هو super dentist. He can do everything. No. You have some point, you should stop and refer the case. You should refer it to a specialist, especially if it's a difficult case. Maybe you are a talent endodontist or talent dentist, but you don't have the instrument. Like you have one of your colleagues, he has the endoscope, he has the cone beam, so he can deal with this case more than you. In one of the meta-analysis concluded that treatment-related, patient-related, and tooth-related factor influence the prognosis of periradicular surgery. these three factors: treatment-related, patient-related, tooth-related factors. The clinician, ركزوا على هالنقطة يا شباب. The clinician may be able to control treatment-related factor, but unfortunately, not a patient-related or tooth-related factor, which is already existed. You can't deal with it. Look to this case of indication for referral. Periapical lesion associated with second molar, lower second molar, and the close proximity to the inferior alveolar nerve. So the referral is mandatory in order to perform under strict and advanced surgical procedure in order to improve the outcomes. Root amputation and hemisectioning, we still within the classification of the endodontic surgery. Root amputation, حكيت عليه بالمحاضرة راحت. بس الهيميسكشنينج is the removal of the root with corresponding crown from the forcation level of multi-rooted tooth. Look to this case. I have a radiograph with problem in the major root, total major resection and hemisectioning of the tooth, removal of the major root, and the final prosthesis. Finally, I have the radiograph of the hemisected tooth with good survival factors. Another case of root amputation and hemisectioning. Look to the smaller. Resection of the major root in order to survive the distal root. Then with successful root canal treatment, you can use it as an abutment and do your prosthesis. If the management with canal treatment and root tube excision is not possible, hemisectioning and amputation are performed in the presence of the root of inadequate bone level, especially in class 3 and class 4, اللي حكينا عليهم بالمحاضرة السابقة من عندي periodontal involvement of class 3 and class 4. Look to this case. Wide radiolucency in the major root. Palatal and distal canal are filled. Resection of the major root. You see the survival rate and survival of the prosthesis. So you save the dentition, you fabricate a prosthesis, you didn't sacrifice the whole tooth by the hemisectioning. طبعا بالمناسبة الهيميسكشنينج إلى ظروف الخاصة وإلى الانديكيشن والكونترا انديكيشن ممكن أن نحضر له محاضرة كاملة بالمستقبل بس أريدك تعرف أنه هو part of endodontic surgery. نجي على النقطة الكونترافيرسيز بالإندودونتيك سيرجري اللي هي الـ use of regenerative technique in the apical surgery. هل أحتاج أن أسوي bone grafting and membrane or not? When, where, why? The concept of guided tissue regeneration, اللي هو GTR, is derived from periodontal regeneration therapy for periodontal disease. هو كجزء مكمل للcomprehensive treatment. Periapical tissue regeneration will occur predictably after endodontic surgery if intra and extra oral infection are controlled. اللي شلون control الinfection by good inoculation, good resection, and complete debridement. Indication of GTR technique in endodontic surgery are limited. ركزوا لي على هالنقطة. Limited. So it's not a routine. أنت مو تستعمله لكل الحالات. لا. It is limited. شنو هي الحالات؟ أولا combined endo perio-lesion, endodontic periodontic lesion, through and through bone lesion, complete perforation from buccal to lingual, large periapical lesion, almost involve the alveolar crest. بهالحالات أني أقدر أستعمل الguided tissue regeneration وطبعاً المفروض أستعمل biocompatible material at least approved by FDA. Possible pre-surgical, intra-surgical, and post-surgical complication of GTR in endodontic surgery must be prevented to avoid the failure. Okay? Look to this case. انتبه لي هنا ايش ده احكي اني ده احكي على الفيلير مالت اتكلم عن الفيلير مالت بون جرافت افتر اندودونتيك سيرجري سو فيرست اوف اول ريفليكشن اوف ذا فلاب لوك تو ذس فول بوني ديفكت فولد وذ جرانيوليشن تيشو لوك تو ذس ذا بريفيوس جرافتنج ماتيريال اند هير ذا سكسسفول ريتريتمنت إذن شنو ملخص هالحالة؟ أحد الزملاء اشتغل endodontic surgery استعمل ال bone graft in an appropriate way lead to formulation of a scar and unsuccessful treatment فلهذا second intervention removal of a granulation tissue complete inoculation and do it in a standard way the platelet concentration either PRP or PRF, platelet-rich plasma or platelet-rich fibrin, in combination with bone graft, beta TCP, could be recommended as an alternative bone graft. The beta, tricalcium phosphate, beta TCP, is an alloplastic widely used in periapical surgery. To enhance new bone formation. شنو ميزاته؟ إنه has osteoconductive, not osteoinductive, no, osteoconductive properties. PRF and beta tricalcium phosphate allograft used for periapical healing following conclusion can be drawn. شنو هي؟ شنو الاستنتاجات اللي طلعوا بيها الباحثين من استعمال البيتا تي سي بي مع البي ار اف سبيشالي بي ار اف اديشن اوف بي ار اف تو بي تي سي بي اللوغراف اكسلريت ذا ريجنريشن كاباسيتي وين ات يوزد ان كومبينيشن اولا راح يزيد الفعاليه مالت البونيغرافت اذا استعملناهم سوا they give a predictable clinical and radiographical evidence of bone formation اذا السكسس ريت مالتي مال البونيغرافت راح تزيد look to this case I have a big lesion pre-surgical exposure bonegraft material membrane and the final radiograph You see, I have a complete healing. GTR technique could improve periapical wound healing in through and through bone lesion and possible in case where large periapical lesion. مثل ما حكينا قبل شوية عدة articles نشرت بهذا الخصوص بس as a great indication sorry as a specific indication or as a main indication for this to this point there is no clear there is no clear evidence There is no clear evidence of the uses and the percentage of improvement of PRF with TCP. Look to this case. Radiograph with two preapical lesions, raising of the flap, use of PRF with bone graft, mixing together. Then after application, we use the membrane. And finally, we have a great success rate. To this point, what are the percentage of success rate compared to the non-mixed or non-use? So vague, but there is a success rate. Based on current available data, there is a significant evidence that GTR technique may improve the outcome of bone regeneration after endodontic surgery, especially where if we have perioendo lesion. When periodontal lesion was present, GTR appeared to allow a great regeneration of periodontal and bone tissue compared to negative control. Possible benefit of GTR technique is associated دائماً مع الكلاس 2 والكلاس 3 lesion اللي حكينا عليهم. Also, the use of good material gonna improve the success rate. Look to this case. Periapical lesion. And again, clinically always larger than radiographically. بعدين أنا حضرت الـ PRF multi مع الـ tricalcium, put it inside the bone graft, the bunny defect, the healing 3 months, 6 months, 9 months, and 1 year. So you look to the success rate and compare between the 12 month and pre-op. You're gonna find the healing is perfect. نيجي هنا على دراسة أدق أو مفهوم أدق لل treatment of bony defect after endodontic surgery with mixture between PRF and TCP. Look, I have this CT scan with bony defect. PRP, المكسشر مالتي اللي حكينا عليه. بعدين after apical inoculation, insertion of the mixture, and look to the post-op CT scan. أصدقائي انتبهوا على الأرقام. I have the density of the bone. مثل ما تعرفون, the density of the bone measured in CT scan by unit called Hounsfield. نشوف اني من 2 هاونسفولد قفزت الى 635 هاونسفولد in 6 months, then in 1 year الى 1000. That means 1000 times the improvement. Okay, this is a CT scan study. Another case, same indication, same procedure. Also, jumped from 33 to 622 and 1000, also by mixture of PRF and bone graft. GTR هو عامل مساعد يا جماعة, مو عامل رئيسي. العامل الرئيسي بالسكسس عندي هو الـ good surgical procedure. Good inoculation, good resection. The combined technique, مثل ما حكينا, راح يكون إلى great improvement in the through and through lesion. The type of the lesion that worse the prognosis. إمتى أنا أتوقع عندي the prognosis gonna be worse? إذا عندك large lesion, more than 5 mm. Lesion located in the lower teeth. Defect with periodontal involvement. And through lesion. لهذا دائما أنا استعمل GTR in these cases. Another example. look the comparison in 3 months from a huge periapical lesion in a bone regeneration procedure with mixed lesion. Now, شباب هسه بعد ما حكينا على كل الستاندرد تكنيكس هسه starting from this slide we gonna to the end we gonna talk about the highly advanced technique بالإندودونتيك osteotomy bone window osteotomy. This technique is an excellent approach to preserve the bone and using an autologous graft for the surgical site. يعني راح استعمل نفس الجرافت مال المريض. امتى الانديكيشن مالتي؟ عندي intact or near intact وراح احكي عليها بالتفصيل شنو الانتاكت وشنو النير انتاكت. Buccal and cortical plate with large bony cavitation. يعني الكورتيكال بليت مالتي سيف. اهم شيء استعمل البييزو. هنا مو استعمل راوند بير اور هاند بيس. Look to this case. I gonna start from scratch. I have a periapical lesion associated with the first molar and there is a post and the crown. Look to the lesion. Confirmed with CT scan. Flap reflection, formation of the window, and we're gonna talk about it. Removal of the window, exposure of the root tips, after cleaning, resection, allogenous bone graft, then return back the same window, and look to the healing. Post-operatively. This is simple window technique. We're gonna go in full detail about it. Look to another case of anterior teeth. I have this pre-operative radiograph. After exposure, window formation, then bone window osteotomy, and standard endo microsurgery. They return back the window to the same place and follow up. Okay. When I gonna use it? الخوري هو يعتبر من ال pioneer للليد approach or window approach. بس بالبداية كانوا يستعملون قبل السيتي سكان. مع تطور السيتي سكان الويندو تكنيك البون ويندو اصبح مور افيلبل اند مور انديكيتد. ليش؟ The bone window approach to the apical region is less invasive, less traumatic, okay, and minimize bone loss in comparison to the traditional osteotomy technique. بس احتاج الكومبيم وفي بعض الاحيان احتاج الى كات كام وياهم وفي بعض الاحيان راح اسوي سيرجيكال تابلت هاي راح احكي عليها كلها. Look to this x-ray again another case of window technique. Formulation of the window, removal of the lid, complete inoculation of the periapical area, retain back the window and 12-month follow-up. مثل ما تكلمت سابقاً هالتكنيك يعتمد كلياً على CBCT. So what are the indication in this case? CBCT scan show the three-dimensional location of anatomical structure. Hello? Also, it's gonna be very sensitive for the bony defect in the especially buccal area. زين شنو الشيء المهم إليه as a combeam related to the window technique? It's gonna measure the thickness of cortical plate precisely, يعطيك precise, and also indicate the bone density, not only in the cortical, but also in the medullary bone, and the margin of the radiolucent area. If any radiographical evidence of thickness of 1 mm and more, هذا يعتبر indication للويندو تكنيك. يعني يا شباب أنا إذا عندي fenestration or عندي through and through lesion, الويندو تكنيك is not applicable. You should have at least cortical bone of 1 mm. Look to this case. I have a CT scan with molar with periapical lesion, but the problem is very close to the inferior alveolar nerve. For that, I should be very careful when I'm planning my osteotomy. And if you look here, I have a good thickness of the cortical bone. For that, the bone window technique is indicated in this case. The CBCT scan in the axial view gonna show the thickness of cortical bone need to be measured at three locations: apical margin, level of root tip, level approximately 3 mm coronal to the root apex, okay? Moreover, CT scan verify the approximate relation between the lesion and normal anatomical structure look like inferior alveolar nerve and maxillary sinus. بس الأهم من هذا راح يعطيني measurement للأبيكال margin, level of the root tip, and level approximately 3 mm coronal to the root apex. من أجيب هاي الانفورميشن أجمعها كلها سوا أقدر أشوف إذا الويندو تكنيك مالتي applicable or not. Look to this case, the same case with different views, if starting from axial coronal sagittal to have the full view. إذا عندي two roots or the complete inoculation of the cystic lesion is also indicated for bone window technique. The two root apices can be visualized by preparing one single bone window. يعني أسوي window واحدة راح يبين عندي two roots. Look to this case. I have a molar with failure endodontic treatment, strict indications for endodontic surgery. So the decision was according to the axial CT scan, we have a good thickness of bone in the axial and the coronal and the sagittal. So we decided to go with window technique. First of all, a preparing of rectangular bone window. Then, بعدين شلون اشيلها؟ اخلي اسوي hole in the middle of the window. يعني شلون اسوي لزمه؟ مثل الهاندل حتى اشيل هاي الويندو. Then lifting the bone block. اوكي. اسوي لها سيفنج زين، اني هاي البون ويندو وين اخليها؟ الافضل انه اخليها بهانس بلانك سوليوشن. اذا ما عندي نورمال سلاين امري لله. Inoculation of the lesion, root resection, root filling material, اللي هي الستاندرد اندودونتيك بروسيجر، then retain bag of my window. و بالاخير البون هيلينج مالتي. اذا مجرد اسوي ويندو I remove the block then retained back 6 month 12 month نشوف السي تي سكان نشوف كومبليت هيلينج عندي بال لاست فولو اب. وها زين انا مو بس عندي اني اللي هو الكومبليت هيلينج the good things also that we have non-harassing the vital structure, which is the inferior alveolar nerve. شنو فوائد البون ويندو؟ Prevent the formation of large residual bone defect. Especially when, if I have a complete, I need a complete inoculation of large cystic lesion. In addition to that, it's gonna achieve a successful treatment. ليش? Because I'm gonna work locally. This is another case. Look to the CT scan of the upper molar. Flap reflection, window removal, saving of the window, enhanced plaque solution, root to presection, then filling material and retain bag of the window. Immediate post-operative and 6 months later. You see the healing? Okay. فالبون ويندو تكنيك an excellent technique to saving the bone. Precise procedure. Anatomical analysis of mandibular posterior teeth for endodontic microsurgery. The cortical bone, concave shape in addition to close proximity of the inferior alveolar nerve. We should understand the anatomical structure of the surgical site in order to prevent or reduce the post-operative complication. As the position of the teeth become more posteriorly, the buccal bone become more thicker, and the distance of mandibular canal become closer. يعني عندك thick bone, well, mandibular canal closer. The first premolar and the first molar major root are often in contact with buccal cortical bone. فلهذا you should be very careful when you're planning. Look to this classification of the root tip. Class one or type one separate, which is the root, is located in the cancellous bone without contact the buccal cortical bone. يعني هذه perfect indication for window technique. Type two, contact. The root is in contact with buccal cortical bone. And here we should see where is the contact. The third, which is the root is piercing, exposed outside the cortical bone. يعني هنا ال window technique is contraindicated. ال CAT CAM guided surgical template انطاني مساحة أوسع بالعمل when I applied to the endodontic surgery. يعني ال guided مو بس بالimplant لا. بكل السيرجريز especially in endodontic surgery. Look to this case. I have a periapical lesion, okay, in the molar. So scanning of the data, fabricate of the template, okay. Then I brought this template and I applied it in the case and I did my window through the prefabricated template. يعني هنا شنو الادفانسز اللي صارت عندي؟ بييزو ويندو جايدد يعني انا الويندو مالتي مو سويت اعتباطا لا سويت اعتمادا على جايد which is gonna give me a precise location of the root tip here after the root tip for my preparation شوف the post operative radiograph and شوف ال healing مالتي شلون صار So the healing is excellent by using all this new innovation or these advances in technology. There is another technique called targeted endodontic microsurgery, which is go to the target, the most precise one. Look to this case. By fabricating a cube shape guide, look. Then, doing a trefine, even not a window, trefine. انت تشوفون الادفانسز مالتي شلون صارت من الويندو من الهيوج اوستيوتومي الى ويندو الى trefine. هذا كله بسبب شنو؟ بسبب الادفانسز بالارمامنتاريوم. Another case of guided using a three fine pair. Using the three fine pair, look. First of all, I have a CT scan. Then I fabricate my three fine pair with the use of guided surgical stent, flap reflection, application of my surgical guide, and then go through the sleeve direct to the lesion. And you see, so I have a very small opening. Look, guys, it's look like pain. Just you're gonna draw a small window. Finally, as a conclusion, وصلنا إلى conclusion من المحاضرات الثلاثة. In past endodontic surgery was often viewed as a procedure of desperation. Last resort, الأمل الأخير. There was also limited in understanding in the endodontic disease and the treatment failure. هذا الكونسبت تغير بمرور الأيام بالديفلوبمنت of a new armamentarium, a new microsurgical technique, enhanced illumination and magnification, advances per root and filling material will improve the surgical outcome. Endomicrosurgery have a high long term of 5 to 9 years. يعني الاندودونتيك مايكروسيرجري السرفايفر ريت مالته زاد الى نسبه 95%. الانفلونس هو due to advance in surgical techniques and armamentaria. بالقرن اللي راح كان كل الماتيريال تعتمد على زنك اوكسيد ايجينول او سوبر ايبا او امالغام. Nowadays we depend on calcium silicate cement MTA. البيوسيراميكس is more available nowadays. The data in the literature suggested that appropriate now. هاي رسالتي الأخيرة. Appropriately selected clinical cases. Endodontic surgical procedure approach give good and reliable result. اختار الحالة واختار المريض. Good communication, good patient selection. You're gonna have a good treatment plan and you're gonna end up with great result. Should be preferred over the decision to extract of the tooth. And subsequent placement of implant therapy. يعني أنا اللي قادم من بحر الجراحة واللي كل شغلي implant أقولكم وأعترف إنه لو خيروني بين الإندودونتيك سيرجري أو implant definitely أختار الإندودونتيك سيرجري. الفوليوم of pre-operative pre-apical lesion had a significant effects in the outcome of endodontic surgery. We can expect favorable prognosis إذا عندك lesion as a volume وليس as a diameter under 50 cubic millimeter. Any question related to the all three lectures?
أنا دكتور شكرا جزيلا على ال very informative lecture. يعني the way يعني we think about it إنه فعلا I totally agree with you إنه يعني إحنا مو ضد السيرجري ولا ضد الإمبلانت فلا لكنه really كل case أو كل treatment it has got its يعني limitations. ولذلك we should use them يعني to the limits. فمثلا احنا كإندو تريتمنت يمكن انا شفت كم كيس اللي هي بيها very short roots remaining after the surgery, maybe other people, they might say, well, this has a poor prognosis. But as a conservative person, we really want to keep the teeth as much as possible and keep them a couple of years and then and refer to implants. Because even implants, they've got their problems. They're not just a complete treatment without any problems. Whenever we've got a tooth, we should try as much as possible to keep it. Well, I'm very content that really we don't have many questions from our audience, because it's so very, very clear. But I thank you very much for the clarification of how endo surgery has improved greatly. And I remember when I was a student, we used to use amalgam and cements to.
And the straight bear. Do you remember the straight surgical bear?
Yeah, for retrograde. And now, even in Indo treatment, people are not using gutta percha. They're using MTA. They use MTA as a bioceramic material to fill all the canal. Now, this is very costly, but it's costly now. But maybe in the future, it will be not very costly, and we will be using only biocompatible material, and we would get rid of anything called non-biocompatible material entering to the oral cavity. I thank you very much, Dr. Aid. يعني احنا تعبناك هالثلاث
ابدا دكتور انت تامروني امر وانا بالخدمه
الله يخليك لا واحنا ما راح نعوفك بصراحه
ان شاء الله دكتور خادم لكم دائما انا
لا خادم ربك انا اشكرك اخ عزيز ودكتور عبد الله طبعا راح دائما يكون اللينك ان شاء الله حتى
اتشرف بيك وبي دكتور واعزاز علي
الله يخليك عين احنا طبعا بال in appreciation of your efforts we're going to present to you a certificate of participation. It's going to be sent to you by and it's going to be posted بال مكتب الإعلامي مع النقابة و يعني هو فد شيء بسيط للجهد العلمي الكبير لحضرتك يعني you showed but only يعني we want to
show هذا افتخر واعتز بيها
اشكرك جدا وما قصرت وان شاء الله نشوف حضرتك و يعني للمستقبل يعني على خير ويعني في يعني ان شاء الله نخلص من كوفيد 19 هذا
ان شاء الله هانت دكتور هانت ان شاء الله
الله كريم الله كريم ان شاء الله خير
ان شاء الله
اشكرك جدا يعني دكتور عبد الله اذا حبيت انه تنهي الـ 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 المحاضره
تمام دكتور يعني بما انه وصلنا للنهايه نتقدم بالشكر الجزيل الى الدكتور رائد الدريمي على المحاضره اللي قدمها ونتقدم بالشكر الى استاذ الدكتور حسين الحويزي على ادارته لهذه المحاضرات وان شاء الله مثل المحاضرات السابقه راح تشوفون المحاضره مسجله على اليوتيوب ضمن صفحه المكتب الاعلامي لنقابه الاطباء الاسنان وحاليا راح ننهي الميتنج وشكرا جزيلا للجميع
شكرا